Hello friends, welcome to Vectatapedia. Today we are going to discuss how Hive is going to work on Hadoop environment. So if suppose I am going to submit a query, how Hive is convert as a MapReduce job and it's going to be executed on Hadoop environment and it's picking up the output. That is we are going to discuss now. So this is the overall architecture, but it's not visible in this screen. So we just plan to go one by one. Okay, so this is the, let's say for example we are going to submit a code like select column underscore one, and with respect to of column how many records available, that is I'm going to check it out from table group by column underscore one. This is my query I'm going to execute. Via Hive. So UA is nothing but that is Hive shell or CLI or Bline or whatever. So this query you are going to submit via this environment only. Once the query will be reached into that UI, the query will be submit to driver as an execution part. Driver just sending this query to compiler whether this query is correct or not. First compiler just validate about your keywords of your query. All the keywords are available in as per our syntax or not. Once compiler is verified, then only it will be moved into your metadata request. If suppose your keyword is spelling mistake or if it is any incorrect keyword that you provided, it will be throwing error from the compiler itself. If suppose keyword is correct, but certainly the tables or any other information is provided incorrectly, then Metastore will be validate this table is available or not like that. So everything is fine, then only it will be reached into the Metastore properly, and Metastore will be giving the about the table information like what is the table name and what is the path of this table data is available and what file format they have used and what are the column is available in this table, what are the data types available in this table. All the information will be captured via Metastore and it will be sent to compiler. In Metastore there is a three types of Metastore is available: embedded, local and remote Metastore. So any one of the Metastore will help you to getting this metadata information. Once the request will be reached into the compiler, compiler is sending the plan to driver again. Just request for the planning and finalized plan will be sent to driver again. Driver request to execution engine to execute this command. Okay, so execution engine, any execution engine will be supported like a Hive, MapReduce, Spark or test execution engine. Any one of the execution engine will be taking care of this plan. If suppose what you mentioned that execution engine, based on that only it will be selected. So if suppose I'm going to select the MapReduce execution engine, this will be transferred as a MapReduce job here. And based on the MapReduce job, it's going to be interact to your Hadoop environment. So execution engine only will be convert your query as a job to Hadoop environment. And once it will be reached the job into resource manager creating as a MapReduce job with some particular number like job underscore 0001 something, it will be create some number. This is actual job number. So based on the job number only, it will be validated whether that all the task is completed, because one job have multiple tasks based on the mapper and reducer and shuffling part. It just validate and the task will be running with respect to of your node manager. So multiple node manager will be working on multiple data node and fetching the final output via with your data node operation. Yeah, here is available. Name node can produce all the metadata information about the data, about the file object. You suppose one data node is going down, where the replication data and actual similar data is available, that information will be sent by your name node and then only it will be processed. This all will be complete via your mapper reduce task, and finally this output will be sent back via your Hadoop environment to execution engine. So this is the execution engine flow. As well, execution engine need a confirmation from name node, DFS operation, everything is completed or not, that information. Again, job, the particular job was created based on the resource manager, right? That job. So everything will be sent as a flag to Hive execution engine. All the flag will be received properly, then when the Hive execution engine will be considered, okay, this is the final output for this particular job, like that. Then send the result back to your driver. So driver will be picked up the data. What is the query you provided? Based on the output, you will be get via driver. Driver will be resend the output to whatever the mode you have used, CLI or Beeline or Hive CLI directly. That output will be transferred via UI only. So this is query. Based on the query output and this fetch result output will be the same. Based on the job number only, it will be received. Okay, so this we are going to see in simple example now in Hive CLI. I'm using Hive. You can try with the Beeline or some other CLI also. Yeah, Hive is starting now. I'm using 2.3.6 Hive. Okay, so I just validate the databases. Yeah, we have database. I'm using October 2020 database and I'm showing the tables. We have multiple tables available. I just take it out one Avro table star from Avro limit. Okay, two. So we can see some data. Now I'm going to execute describe formatted Avro. Okay, this is the information about your data. So this is Avro file format and external table, and the data will be stored in this directory. And Avro format we have used. And this many column and with respective column type is available. We have seen something. Now I'm going to execute via some aggregate process. Select. I'm going to take total count of number of states from this table. Okay, this is the query I'm executing now. Now you can see it is creating a job. MapReduce job reducer will be validated and now it is creating a job. This is a job number. Just nothing but resource manager will be receiving the request. It will be created as a job, right? Same like the query we have passed, it will be creating as a job. Now in this job we have multiple MapReduce job that is going to be processed. So stage one we have seen number of mapper as a one, number of reducer as a one. So this is a two task is going to be run in the backend with respect to your node manager. So this is the process is running now. Okay, so job is completed. 100% mapper is over. Once mapper is over, reducer part is completed. So this is the output. This output of your query. Okay. If suppose I'm doing some mistakes in this query, it's throwing some error. You can see. So cannot recognize input near, which means compiler itself it is just rejecting your query. This query is not a valid, we cannot recognize it. Like that it just validate and will be sending it. If all the queries properly available, it's just going to execute in your environment. Okay, so this is the output as you are getting as a seventh step of fetch result and will be sent via your execution engine to send result. I have used Hive CLI for this query. I'm getting some output. in Hive CLIs. Likewise, Hive is going to communicate with your Hadoop environment and process it. Thank you, friends. We will be discussing a new topic in the next video.